Goodness. Hi, guys. Welcome back. If you guys can't tell, I am in a good mood because I am going to Napa by the end of this month. So I want to share with you my tips on how to plan the best wine tour. Now, not to toot my own horn, but homegirl has been doing wine tours for a while. We've gone to different continents. We've gone to different regions, so I think I have a good handle on the wine tour scene. You want to find out how to look fabulous, how to go to the right places, how just to have a good time? Keep watching. All right, so yes, I am going to be wine touring in Napa, and I am so excited. It's been so long. I was supposed to go last year. And you know where else I was supposed to go? I was supposed to go to Spain. I was supposed to go to Rioja and I was gonna do a wine tour there. I had it all planned out, I had it all booked, and then COVID. So today we're gonna go over how to plan a wine tour. And I know there are tons of wine tours that you could just buy that are super easy, just pay and they'll take care of everything for you. The logistics, the reservations, all of that. I totally get it if you're in an international place or like if you just don't want to be bothered, like yes, get a wine tour. But I want to open up the experience of like being able to plan out your own wine tour for the everyday person. And it's really not that hard because I've been wine touring since I was in college. And if a college student can figure it out, you guys can figure it out. And reasons why you want to plan your own wine tour is because it's fun. It gives you the flexibility to explore and try different wineries. And it's less expensive. If you are up for it, it is a win-win-win. First step that I have just to get a lay of the scene is like, what's the mood? Match the wineries to the mood. Who's going? Is this an event? Are we trying to be bougie? Are we trying to be chill? Are we just trying to be drunk? Pick your wineries based on the mood of the group. Not just your mood, the mood of the group. Every region has a range. Even Napa, there are some that are more like for party buses and there's some that are more family oriented. There's no glitz and glam. Those are great experiences if you want to really get to know the producer, how they make it, all that stuff. And sometimes you get extra pours too. So those are kind of nice and more chill. But on the other hand, like let's say you're there for the pictures, then you want to go to wineries that have that nice scenery, that nice setup. I personally think that 2 to 3 wineries in a day is like the perfect number. I have done 4 to 5 wineries in a day and it's aggressive. It's pretty aggressive. If you're up for it and you spit or whatever, or like maybe you got high tolerance, go for it. But I think 2 or 3 is really the perfect number because there is wine tasting fatigue. And once that 4th and 5th winery rolls around, it seems more of a chore than enjoyment at that point. So I think 2 to 3 is the best number. We gotta talk about budget, okay? Budget will dictate where you go and how many wineries that you go to. What I do for each region is I look around and I will just check out some wineries to get a sense of what the tasting prices are. So for instance, for Napa, it's around $40 to $80. Napa's pretty expensive. Where in that range do you want to fall? You know, I think my group wants to be a little bit more chill, but we definitely want to be cute. We want to be like bougie on a budget, but like still want to look very posh. I think that's what most people want. Within that range of 40 to 80, I kind of stuck more to the 40-50 side of things. And if I saw things that were 75, 80, 100, I was like, that's cute. It looks really nice, but I don't think my group wants that. I don't think that's the vibe. So let's take those out. So the budget will help to dictate which wineries that you go to. The next thing is, we can't avoid it. I know people don't like to do it, and that's why people want to just plan their tours, but it's the logistics. Honestly, for me, I'm a Virgo, so I thrive on this stuff. So what I'll do is I will have a spreadsheet of the wineries that I've researched that fit my budget, fit my mood, and I will put in the prices of it, all the tastings. Then I will look up the availability of all of them, because some of them are more competitive. Like, some of them you have to book way in advance, some of them are walk-in, some of them are appointment only. And then this is very, very importante: map it out. So I will go to Google Maps and I'll map out these wineries. And if I see any of the wineries that are like 2 hours out of the way, or like really, really far from like a cluster of them, then like I have to like think like, hey, do I want to drive an hour out to go to this winery? Most wineries are open from 10 to 5 p.m. So that's not a huge window to wiggle with if you have like two or three wineries, right? You're going to do either a morning one or like noon one to like afternoon one, and that's really going to be it. So you want to plan out and space out each of your tours. Why? Because you really don't want to be like stressing out that you have to make it to another tour and rush your group like cattle. We don't really want that. No, we want to be relaxed, be able to have like pictures, look cute, maybe just enjoy the grounds. Like, you want to be able to space it out. If I'm feeling frisky, I'll have some bonus wineries that are walk-in appointments that aren't that expensive to kind of add in if we have a lot of time. So I like to add some flexibility in it. The next thing that I want to talk about is schedule eating. Make sure you guys eat, because I've been on some wine tours where people get hangry and it's no longer fun. It's game over. It's game over when people get hangry, especially when they've had some wine. In that like little spreadsheet thing, I schedule some time for lunch, or sometimes I will buy food ahead of time to do a picnic, or sometimes I know that a place will sell food, or like if you really are doing it nice and bougie, some places will have food available that you can buy at the wineries. And then lastly, have fun. If you plan all of that out and have that all done, forget about it. Like, I plan this out, like sometimes I plan this out a month, 2 months, 3 months beforehand. Then it's like set it and forget it. Once you have it all laid out, you can just chill. And then the day of, you don't have to worry about, where am I gonna go? What am I gonna do? You have it all planned out. You got your itinerary, you can share it with all your friends. They know what's going on, how much things are going to cost, and there's no surprises. There are no surprises. And it's so nice when you do that. You can really enjoy your time there. I'm going to be going to Domaine Carneros and Etude. Those are the two wineries I'm going to. So I'm just only going to go to two, because I think my group can only handle two. So we're going to two in Napa, and I'm so, so excited. And I can't wait to share with you guys that trip. So definitely take out these tips on how to plan your wine tour, and have fun, you guys. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. We cover everything here, y'all. We cover some, you know, wine reviews. We cover some knowledge. We cover just me having a good time, things that might be useful to you, and maybe you just kind of like to see me get stupid. So follow me on my channel, and cheers, you guys.